Greetings, Helldivers. Today, I have a real banger of a guide for you. We'll be diving in deep and learning a lot about what makes one of the most fun and unique weapon classes in the game tick. Before we start, a warning for those of you who are numerically allergic. There will be a lot of numbers and tables going on, but I've done my best to make sense of my findings here and made it so that you can use what you find here as a reference whenever you need to. At the end of the video, I'll share my current favorite loadout against the Terminates, the Laserlight Exterminator, along with some strategies to go. No matter where you end up while watching this video, I'll make sure there's always something you can take away from it. So let's get it on. As of this video, we currently have a total of 4 laser weapons. The last 5 scythe, the last 7 dagger, the last 16 sickle, and the last 98 laser cannon support weapon. Laser weapons share the defining characteristic of building up heat instead of needing to reload. And as long as you never burn out the heatsink and let the weapon cool down, you can functionally have infinite ammo on all of them. Laser weapons also tend to fire a beam of concentrated energy at a location, applying many ticks of damage in a very short period of time. The sickle, however, is an exception to this, as it works exactly like an assault rifle rather than a conventional laser weapon. If you've picked up any of the laser weapons before, you've probably seen their stats page, which really doesn't tell you very much at all. So me being me, and a defining feature of this channel, is that I like to apply numbers to things that don't normally have numbers to them, to make better sense of it. And in doing so, I've created a couple of tables to help you better understand how all of the laser weapons work. But a little disclaimer before we get into those tables. As we don't have a detailed numeric UI or a testing ground to conduct controlled experiments, the numbers you see on the tables are gathered through my best efforts over many hours and rounds of field testing, observations, and analysis. I won't claim that these numbers here are 100% accurate, but I can comfortably say that they are at least 95% of the way there. Not precise, but good enough to provide you with an informed understanding of things. This game is also beautifully intricate in that there are a number of external factors which may or may not be influencing my tests. We'll get to that in a bit, but in the event I'm wrong about something, and I wouldn't be surprised if I am, I'll make amendments in my pinned comment if anyone can provide me with proof. Now, here is the first of the tables. What we have here is a more detailed profile of all the laser weapons. I've basically tried to fill out the missing pieces of information that we would expect to see at the minimum. Feel free to pause if you want to look at the tables more closely, but some of the observations you can make are: number 1, the sickle likely has the highest DPS out of all the laser weapons, even more than the laser cannon if I were to guess, judging by my personal experience with it. Number 2, compared to the AR-23 Liberator, the sickle has a 17% higher DPS output and a gigantic 86-round magazine, making it the superior assault rifle by far. Number 3, all laser weapons are effective against light armor, with the exception of the laser cannon, which can penetrate medium armor as well. This characteristic means it can damage all but the heaviest of armor, making it a very flexible weapon that has unlimited ammo. To tag on to this point, the laser cannon can also be used to bust open bunker doors and destroy shrieker nests as well, giving it even more utility outside of just killing bugs. And finally, all laser weapons, except for the sickle, deal their damage in ticks, with the laser cannon seemingly having the highest at 10 ticks per second, followed by the sickle's 8 ticks per second, and finally the dagger's rather anemic 5 ticks per second. These damage profile numbers are good for helping you put into perspective just how strong the laser weapons are relative to the other weapons in our arsenal. What is probably going to be more useful to know is this next table. This table is where a good amount of time was spent filling up. It details the hidden characteristics of laser weapons that we really ought to know about. Max sustained fire tells you how long you can fire your laser weapon until its heatsink burns out. Single heatsink output shows you how much damage a single heatsink can dish out before burning out. This is basically its max damage per mag equivalent. Total cooldown shows you roughly how long you'll need to wait if you reach 99% heat on your laser weapon. Cooldown delay indicates how long a laser weapon needs to wait before it can begin the process of cooling down. Reload speed is, well, reload speed. And finally, heat efficiency measures how much time you'll need to spend cooling the weapon down for every second spent using it. The lower the heat efficiency, the better. We'll talk more about heat efficiency in a bit, but for now, let's do a little breakdown. First thing you'll probably notice is that the laser cannon has the longest sustained fire duration of 10 seconds, but also has the longest total cooldown to match at 20 seconds. Meanwhile, the sickle holds the position of having the most damage in a single heatsink at nearly 4.8k, which is double that of the scythe's rather pitiful 2.4k, and it even takes the scythe longer than the sickle to get the damage out as well. A balancing factor for the sickle's powerful damage output is supposedly that it is the only laser weapon that has an intrinsic cooldown delay of 1.5 seconds, unlike all other laser weapons which seemingly begin cooling down immediately after you stop firing. and even then, it still cools faster than the scythe. The reload speed variable indicates that you can spend the reload time to discard a heatsink and reload a new one at a fraction of the total cooldown time. This is a pretty important thing to consider when using laser weapons in the higher difficulties where enemy numbers can be overwhelming. I know, it's easy to think that throwing a heatsink away means throwing away the future infinite ammo potential, but as long as you have at least one heatsink left, you technically still have that potential. Better to reload and get back into the fight than to die waiting for your heatsink to cool. Do note that reloading the laser cannon's heatsink will cause you to stop moving, so only do so when you aren't being chased. Next, let's talk a little bit more about heat efficiency. When we think about factors that affect our heat efficiency, we'd no doubt think about the environmental conditions like icy cold and intense heat. The icy cold condition states that weapons fire slower and that energy-based weapons cool faster. The question is, how much slower and how much faster? Well, according to my tests, the impact is very significant. In the icy cold, your weapons fire about 11% slower. And because fire rate is also tied to heat buildup for our laser weapons, it means we also build up heat slower. You pair this with the total cooldowns being reduced by about 36% from the cold, and suddenly your heat efficiency improves tremendously. This is a small table comparing the sickle under normal conditions versus that in the icy cold. While it loses a bit of DPS, its heat efficiency skyrockets. At a heat efficiency of almost 1, the sickle is practically cooling down for as long as it shoots, giving you over 40% more uptime. The icy cold condition drops your DPS a little in exchange for a huge boost in your sustained damage output, making you more effective in drawn out battles and engagements. On the other hand, the intense heat is the bane of all laser weapons. Under this condition, it reads that it speeds up the heat buildup in weapons. Now, if this were true, it would reduce our maximum sustained fire, meaning you can't fire your laser weapon for long as you'd burn out the heatsink much faster. However, I think either the description is wrong or the effect is wrong. In my testing, I have noted no change to the max sustained fire when comparing clips frame by frame in both normal conditions and under intense heat. Instead, what intense heat actually does right now is increase the total cooldown time for laser weapons by about 22%, which results in a lower weapon uptime of about 20%. Now, there might be another intrinsic factor that affects your heat efficiency as well. However, because repeated testing has shown somewhat inconsistent results, what I'm about to share here is either onto something, or that I've gone completely bonkers because I've spent an unhealthy amount of time trying to verify it. And that is, laser weapons actually cool down faster if they are at higher heat. This is actually how cooling works in real life, where something that is very hot is able to transfer its heat into its surroundings quicker compared to when it's cooler. Here are a handful of tables that I've been using to observe this phenomenon. Notice how the heat efficiency is actually lower at lower levels of heat generated. I know the numbers are marginal and in the grand scheme don't really make that much of a difference, but the fact that it's fairly consistent in this case, I just can't help but suspect something. This is also the scientific basis of how the icy cold and intense heat conditions work. The icy cold makes the difference in temperature between your surroundings and your heatsink that much wider, allowing it to cool even faster. On the other hand, with how the intense heat conditions currently work, it brings the surrounding temperature up, which slows down the rate at which your heatsink can disperse the heat effectively into its surroundings. Alright, that's all for the facts and figures you need to know about the laser weapons right now. If you are still with me at this point in the video, you've probably taken in a lot of information. So, to give you a break, here's a short intermission with a clip of me and some randoms thinking about the same thing at the same time without voice comms. I love it when everyone is on your game without needing comms. If you've made it this far, odds are you might have enjoyed the work you've seen. If you want to see more like this, consider dropping a like and subscribing. Anyway, now that we've learned pretty much everything useful that I can reasonably test about laser weapons, let's put it all into practice with my favorite loadout right now, the Laserlight Exterminator. This build makes full use of the laser weapon's strengths and operates in a way that covers its weaknesses by heat juggling. This build is mostly meant for terminates, but can be somewhat serviceable if you aim for the weak spots on automatons, though I would still recommend bringing other loadouts instead. Our loadout is as follows. We'll want to have the sickle as our primary weapon of choice. As you saw from the tables, it is a very solid option that performs wonderfully for its intended purpose as a fodder killer. This weapon is both effective against terminates and automatons, making it a real jack-of-all-trades weapon to have on hand. For our secondary, we technically don't need to take the dagger, and I wouldn't really recommend it either given how weak it is relative to everything else. if and when we get that data mined grenade launcher pistol, that would 100% be my secondary of choice. Until then, use what you want. For our grenades, you can use what you like. I love impact grenades, so I'll use those. Now, for our stratagems, we'll 100% need to take the laser cannon. It is basically a beefed up scythe that can penetrate medium armor from afar and without having to worry about ammo at any time. We'll also be bringing the scythe with us, in the form of the guard dog Rover. This backpack acts as an additional source of damage and can cover you while you are waiting on cooldowns or if you're engaged in a different direction. Your remaining two stratagem slots are up to you. If you want to be on theme and really live the Laserlight dreams, you have to take the orbital laser for sure. While you only get 3 charges in a mission, the orbital laser provides many tactical benefits when it comes to clearing out an objective or to hold back a breach. Speaking of which, the orbital laser moves around the battlefield, seeking enemies out, but it will prioritize heavy targets like Bile Titans, Brute Commanders, and Chargers over the fodder bugs. If I'm not using the orbital laser, I'll usually load up on anti-armor stratagems since between the laser cannon and the sickle, anything that has medium armor and below can be dealt with already. In this case, I'll usually take the expendable anti-tank rockets and the orbital rail cannon, which rounds out my build nicely. However, I've been playing around with the 500kg bomb, and it's starting to grow on me for this loadout. The strategy for this build is simple. Juggle your heatsink cooldowns between weapons and prioritize clearing fodder for your team. Deploy expendable anti-tank rockets and orbital rail cannons on enemies as necessary. When it comes to juggling heat, always try to buy as much time as you can for your laser cannon to cool down, since it has the best armor penetration potential among your laser weapons. If you have to burn through a heatsink on the sickle to afford more time, then do so. You have 6 extra heatsinks to burn through, and a single supply drop fully restores them. So don't worry about saving heatsinks. While one exterminator is good, 2 is probably best in my opinion. And although very pretty to look at, I wouldn't recommend having 4 people run this same loadout since you'll probably be really lacking in the anti-armor department at this rate. Okay, this was one hella long video which I hope lives up to being a great big guide to you. If you've enjoyed the work and effort done here, once again, consider dropping a like and subscribing. I plan to give every bit of our arsenal the same deep dive in the future. And as you can see, there's going to be a lot of work to be done. What do you think of the laser cannon in the game? I know the scythe and dagger probably need a little more love in terms of buffs, but otherwise I think the sickle and the laser cannon are in a good place. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments below. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Over and out, Helldivers.